Hey guys, Mike from Nerd Problems Gaming here, and welcome to Nerd Problems Gaming, the channel where we go through the good and bad of everything nerdy to make sure you spend your time on the best of the best. In today's video, I'll be doing a review of Arkham Asylum, so stay tuned. Now, I remember when this game first came out, it was kind of a big deal, right? Everybody was talking about it. It was pretty popular, but I actually never picked it up. So I didn't really know what the hype was about. And flash forward, I don't even know at this point, probably 5-10 years later, I decided to actually pick it up. And so one thing that I noticed right off the bat, this game was pretty similar to kind of like Marvel's new Spider-Man game. Now, I guess in hindsight, it's probably the other way around, right? That game is probably a little bit like this game. But one thing to point out too, when it comes to the Batman game here, you don't necessarily need to be like a hardcore Batman fan, right? You know, I've definitely watched all the Batman movies, but I definitely have not really read the comics or really watched a ton of the TV show, except for maybe when I was little growing up. And so that's one thing that I kind of liked about this game, is that I wasn't necessarily super hardcore in the series, but it really brought to light some of the characters that I remember seeing bits and pieces of in the cartoon, you know, characters even outside of that as well. And then what's pretty cool is that as you're going around, basically the story is that Joker kind of tricks you into being trapped inside Arkham Asylum. And so you are taking him to the asylum, and then it kind of flips around and then you're actually trapped in there. And he's kind of manipulating behind the scenes, releasing the supervillains, right, as you're stuck in this asylum. And so, like I said, it kind of has a very similar feel to like the Spider-Man game, where you have different tasks that you have to do. There's also like a detective mode, so it kind of does like x-ray vision almost, and then you can explore and find clues, and you know, the Riddler actually leaves different question marks and puzzles around, so it's kind of fun to be able to explore and discover those different things. It also has kind of like an action RPG element to it, so as you kill bad guys, as you discover these hidden treasures, hidden things around the state, you actually gain experience points, and then you can use those to power up Batman. So there's different abilities like improving your health, you know, unlocking new combos, kind of enhancements to your gear that you find. And so that's kind of another cool feature as well. So you have like the bat grappling hook, the bat hook, right? And that can really shoot out and then latch onto different ledges, and you kind of shoot up and then climb up them. So again, it kind of is similar to like Spider-Man's web. So you can shoot that and then climb on different areas that have that ability to it. But then you also have like the batarangs and, you know, all kinds of other different gadgets that you can use and utilize throughout the game. And so you don't start with all of those, you kind of unlock them as you play throughout the story. So that aspect was pretty fun too. The battle style, again, is pretty similar to the new Spider-Man game, if you've played that. But it's kind of, like I said, over the shoulder, third person, action RPG. So you're fighting, you're punching, you're kicking, you're doing flips, you can do different combos, learn different moves, and usually you're swarmed with enemies. And so on top of that, there's also like a stealth mode, which is pretty cool, where you can be kind of crawling, lurking around, right, and then dropping down on guys, taking them out from the sky, jumping off ledges, kind of flying in. So there's a lot of cool aspects to this game. Like I said, I had mentioned a little bit before with kind of the lore and the background. So as you discover the different Riddler trophies and aspects throughout the game, you kind of get different character bios, which is neat because, like I said, I didn't know a ton about the lore of Batman beyond the movies. And so getting to learn a little bit about the different supervillains, the good guys on your side as you play, and it kind of has like their backstory, their picture, you know, when they first appeared in the comics or in a movie or whatever the case was. So I thought that was pretty cool and interesting to be able to check out as well. Now, graphics wise, I think they still hold up pretty well. You know, I'm playing it on an Xbox One. I think the Arkham Asylum I got was like a bundle, so you actually got a couple of the different games, and they might have been a little bit more remastered. I'm not exactly sure, but with that, it's cool. Like, they still hold up pretty well. The graphics are pretty good, especially for their time. They were really ahead of their time, you know, when they came out. But It's still a good graphical view. You know, when you're playing the game, looks still pretty realistic. So that's pretty cool with it as well. The game is pretty linear. It feels like it has kind of that open world feel to it, but it is pretty linear in a sense where you just kind of go from area to area. You know, once you've unlocked another area, you can, you know, traverse back, find different secrets, kind of go back as you get new powers and find different things. But the storyline, like I said, is pretty linear in that sense. You know, it's not super long of a game. Again, I was kind of getting used to the mechanics when I played it the first time, but it doesn't take a ton of time, maybe 30 hours tops, I would say, to be able to beat this. Now, granted, I definitely did not unlock everything and anything that there was in the game, but if you went and did that full playthrough and wanted to unlock, find all the different secrets, that would certainly take you a little bit more time as well playing through. There's also some different game modes that you can unlock, which is kind of like a survival mode almost, where it's just wave after wave after wave of enemies, and you can try and figure out as far as you can get. There's a feature to it where you can play as like the Joker, which is kind of fun. So his play style is a little bit different than Batman, so just kind of another unique twist that you can play in the game as well. So I know this game is a series, so I have not played the other ones, but this is the first one I just started. I guess I did start playing Arkham City, which is the second one in the series. But then there's also Arkham Origins and then Arkham Knight, which just came out for like Xbox One, PlayStation 4 era. So definitely looking forward to check those out. But again, definitely let me know in the comments below. Do you like this game? Do you think that it's held up over time? If you've played it recently at all, which one of the series is your favorite? You know, definitely let me know in the comments below. I'm looking forward to playing the other ones. Like I said, I just started the second one, and you know, I'll do a review on that down the road as well when I finish up that game as well. But again, guys, thanks so much for tuning in. If you haven't done so yet, be sure to like this video, hit that like button. It really helps out the channel, and be sure to subscribe to our channel as well and turn on those bell notifications if you haven't done so yet. And then also, if you'd like to help support the channel, help us get videos out faster, help us pick content on our channel and more, definitely consider becoming a patron of ours over at nerdproblemsgaming.com/Patreon. Again, that's nerdproblemsgaming.com/Patreon. You'll see a link on the screen where you can access that as well. And then if you would also like to plug into some of our Let's Plays and our live streams that we do over here on the channel as well, you can actually head on over to nerdproblemsgaming.com/Twitch. Again, that's nerdproblemsgaming.com/Twitch to plug in those live streams and Let's Plays as well. But again, guys, thanks so much for tuning in. Be sure to like this video and subscribe if you haven't yet, and I will talk to you more soon.